Hi, I'm Emily Watkins and this is for Off the Block.
So the Kingham Plough we opened in 2007. It's a dining pub with bedrooms upstairs. We started off with just myself in the kitchen and a commis chef and what I enjoy cooking, which was local seasonal British food. 11 and a half years later, we're still going and we're very loyal customers who come here regularly to enjoy our take on British cuisine. So I think the thing which has really kind of struck me throughout my years cooking, if you're not cooking from the heart, if you don't love what you're doing, the end result on the plate is not going to be delicious. All of our meat here comes from local farmers. With the beef itself, we've got a very small menu which changes frequently. And being a pub, people do like to see a steak on the menu. Our regular steaks we have on the menu is the hanger steak, which is something a little bit unknown. For me, I think it's got fantastic flavour, it's quite different, and it's a really good cut to use.
I'm cooking a beef dish today, which is a take on steak and kidney. So rather than it being served as a pie, we've got a beautiful ribeye steak, which has been hung for 48 days, dry aged. And that's going to be cooked very, very traditionally, pan roasted. And then I'm also cooking to go with that some ox kidney, which I'm cooking in a totally different way. Imagine a water bath and a vacuum bag together with rendered beef dripping, which has been infused with rosemary and bay. And it's got some peppercorns in there as well, which give it a lovely flavour. So it becomes beautifully tender all the way through. Then that's served together with lovely shallot sauce, parsley and some mashed potato. There's two reasons why I'm cooking the kidney in the water bar. First is that I don't really want to intensify the kidney or the urine flavour, which some people can be put off by with kidney. And when you caramelise the flavours, you're pulling the moisture out, you concentrate those flavours, which is beautiful in the ribeye, but I don't want to enhance that in the kidney. Secondly, I'll get a very, very even cooking the whole way through. It will be beautifully tender from outside all the way through, just cooked absolutely to perfection. So I've taken the eye out of the rib of beef. I'm giving it a lovely liberal seasoning with sea salt and black pepper on the outside. I'm pan roasting it, starting off with a bit of oil. I'm going to add some lovely butter into there so you get those nice rich nutty flavours. Add some rosemary and garlic at the end to also help baste it. Let it have a really important good rest. Meanwhile, I'll finish off the garnish. I've got pom puree made with ratty potatoes, some little baby carrots which I'm braising with star anise butter, sugar. When I'm cooking the ribeye steak in the pan, I'm looking for a nice caramelised finish to the outside first of all. I'm going to baste that a bit as well to help that process happen. I'll pop it into the oven for a few minutes just to help that heat, and then I'm going to put it out the oven and let it rest for a good 20 minutes so that the residual heat will finish off cooking the meat perfectly all the way through. Basing this dish very simply, it's all about the cracking ingredients, this dish. You've got, you know, very, very nicely sourced beef here. I don't want to be hiding that behind any sauces. I want to let it be there and, you know, be shown and be displayed. It's going to be one lovely thick slice of the steak. The kidney, again, I'm going to just be doing two slightly thinner slices of that just because it's easier to eat in that way. And then there's going to be this lovely shallot sauce, sticky, sweet, and bringing out those caramelised flavoured and pairing it with the rich sauce as well. So when you order this dish, you're ordering steak and kidney. That is the forefront of the dish and that's what I want to be talking about, and that will be the obvious thing, what's going to draw your eye when it gets put in front of you. Many of our dishes here are takes on old British classics, and obviously steak and kidney, more traditionally done as a pudding, has been something which has been done for generations, yet we've got these wonderful flavours there as well, which obviously go so well together, and it's celebrating those and not hiding them amongst, you know, a load of sauce on, under a pastry top. My key tip is to source your ingredients well. If the beef's the hero of the dish, if it's not good quality beef, it's not going to be a great dish.